showcase. A stage to display one's talents. From the unforgettable moments.
Mankind has achieved his dream!
This is home.
On the biggest stage.
The boyhood dream!
What did we just see?
Daniel Bryan did it! The Miracle Kid!
To the greatest conflicts. From the biggest names. But this showcase is about a man. A man who became a legend.
A man named Stone Cold Steve Austin.
After learning his craft from gentleman Chris Adams, Austin would begin his career in 1989.
I've been very impressed by Steve Austin's ability. He's showing that he has the potential to go a long, long way.
In 1991, the nation got their first glimpse of the future.
From Hollywood, California, 253 pounds, stunning Steve Austin.
Dominating, overpowering, arrogant.
When you bring two world-class athletes together and they mesh as one, you create an unbeatable machine.
And we will be unstoppable as a team. Count on it.
But despite his success, no one saw a superstar. And when injuries sidelined Steve, the future looked bleak.
Next day, I got a FedEx in the mail, said I was fired. I was like, that kind of sucked.
Frustration took over.
There's nothing going my way because the politics kept the biggest potential superstar in wrestling on the ground.
Frustration turned to anger.
We're going to put the U.S. title on you, and then we're going to take you here, and then you're the number one contender, so then you got this world title shot. Well, all that's never happened.
And anger created opportunity.
The ringmaster seems to really have it all. The size, the strength, the agility, the wrestling acumen.
Austin would enter WWE as the ringmaster, but wasted no time turning himself into a more ruthless character.
His peers dubbed him the ringmaster. I would suggest to you, from the look on his face and his attitude, he's a stone cold, if anything.
His moment was finally here.
It's on to bigger and better things after King of the Ring, after I win it all.
And nothing would be the same again.
Hey guys, thanks for hanging out, checking out this video. Look, I know I'm late to this party. To be totally honest, I needed to wait until WWE 2K16 came out. Because let's face it, WWE 2K15 kind of sucked. I mean, really, really sucked. And for yet another confession, it was so bad that I really just didn't even want to play it. So the only thing I was able to offer you guys was those WWE 2K15 predict videos. Oddly enough, though, that had the most views on this channel. So I do recognize that most of you here are WWE Games fans. I'm a huge WWE Games fan. And so now that we finally have what I believe to be a really, really awesome entry into the WWE Games franchise, I'm super stoked to be able to do even more, make more videos for you. And the first series we're going to do here is the 2K Showcase, of course. But we'll also be continuing with the WWE 2K16 Predict videos now. And we'll also be doing my career mode, which I've been able to dabble with a bit. And holy crap, I love my career this year. So we'll definitely do my career videos too. But yeah, I've talked enough. Let's get back to it.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the final match to determine the King of the Ring. It is scheduled for one fall with a one-hour time limit. Approaching the ring, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
And Steve Austin, ladies and gentlemen, went to the emergency room after his first matchup with Wild Man Mark Merrow and had, I think, 16 stitches in his mouth and his tongue. And he has returned here, King, in the King of the Ring.
Well, you know, I got to wonder, on his way to the emergency room, if he saw Jake the Snake Roberts being whisked away in an ambulance.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the King of the Ring, Stone Cold Steve Austin awaits that man. And King, that man, Jake the Snake Roberts, earlier tonight took on Vader.
Oh, man.
It was not a good outing for the Snake.
He got squashed in more ways than one. Watch this big Vader bomb. It's lucky there wasn't a green spot left in the ring.
450 pounds doing internal damage. To what degree, we don't know, but Jake Roberts struggling to even get his reptile bag up on the apron of the ring. And Jake is gingerly walking into the ring. This is a one-fall match in the King of the competition. And the Rattlesnake showing that he is wanting to end this quickly and convincingly.
Oh, look at this, JR. What's he doing to him?
He's stuck in a mud hole and Jake the Snake. And now he is walking it dry. Nothing but high impact intensity from a relentless, unforgiving Stone Cold Steve Austin.
He's pounding poor Jake the Snake like a tent stake. No stopping the Rattlesnake here.
Austin is not going to give any opportunity for Jake Roberts to fight his way back into this match. Nothing pretty about Austin's offense, but it's very effective.
Oh, man, here goes.
Austin off that second turnbuckle, driving his elbows into the sternum, the ribs of Jake the Snake Roberts.
Oh, man, I don't know if poor Jake the Snake is going to be able to get back to his feet.
Very cool. So, yeah, I'm trying not to talk over any cutscenes or anything so we can all share in the experience.
Incredible impact.
Also, mind you, I'm still kind of new at this game. I played a couple of exhibition matches, but I quickly realized that the gameplay is very different. Way better than WWE 2K15, but different nonetheless.
Nicely done. All these power
damn, I already lost the advantage.
Bigger and bigger impact. What an amazing counter that was.
Damn. I still don't have this reversal timing down.
It'd
be so embarrassing if I lose my first 2K showcase match.
Steve Austin making his statement as we speak.
Oh, jeez. All right.
Oh, out of nowhere.
Still ahead, one reversal. Well, now we're even on reversal, so should be okay. Yeah, I quickly realized when I was playing exhibition matches that you need to look at that reversal stock, see how many reversals you got left. And you always want to stay ahead. And it looks like Jake Roberts is slightly ahead. I paid for it in my first like two exhibition matches. And like I said, I'm totally new to this gameplay.
Jake the Snake Roberts was punished earlier by Vader.
And King Stone Cold Steve Austin still feeling the looking to end it here.
Yeah, and I wasn't planning to win there. I just wanted to.
And Steve Austin is doing an excellent
job. Just
want
to see what a dirty pin was like.
Match.
It's pretty cool, actually.
You can imagine every one of those blows, JR. It's like thunder and lightning right into his belly.
Oh, nice.
Every time he moves.
Well, Jake Roberts had a choice. He didn't have to come out here.
Yeah, but this is King of the Ring, and you know you'll do.
I love the crowd reaction
to
this. Yeah, I think like we this always overlook.
Submission.
Here's that freaking retarded.
Here.
There's no escaping this.
I totally don't get that submission system. So yeah, as I was saying, it's easy to overlook how important the crowd reactions are until you play WWE 13, where the crowd boos for everything. It was a really horrible bug, and it just sucks the life out of every match.
He's in big trouble.
All right, so how was I too fast and too slow?
Oh, and a terrific reversal by Steve Austin. What's going to happen now? Austin's in trouble.
Dude, this is unnormal. What the fuck?
Zeroing in on the arm now.
He's really been zeroed in on, but he's still showing some signs of life. Oh, wait, nice reversal.
Oh, crap. What is his signature move?
Here comes Steve Austin.
Well, it's not in the corner.
With a 180, Jake the Snake Roberts, the reversal.
No time to prepare for that one.
He's in full-on attack mode now.
Come on. Finally.
A counter. Oh, nice counter.
All right, well.
Oh, he's in trouble now.
The King of the Ring finals continues here. Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Stunner! Stunner!
With a stunner on Jake the Snake Roberts. And the referee counts as three. And Austin has beaten Jake the Snake Roberts.
Ladies and gentlemen.
That's it?
The winner of this bout.
Really?
And now, reigning King of the Ring, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
And there you see Stone Cold Steve Austin.
The new King of the Ring for 1996. Man, this was some battle, JR.
Austin went through some tough guys to finally get to the top of the mountain. There you see him. What is next for Stone Cold Steve Austin?
I'm just wondering how the rattlesnake's going to look with a crown on his head.
Yeah, if he'll even wear it. I wonder if this is the beginning of bigger things for Stone Cold Steve Austin.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the fourth prestigious King of the Ring, Stone Cold Steve Austin, an incredible victory.
The first thing I want to be done is to get that piece of crap out of my ring. Don't just get him out of the ring, get him out of the WWE, because I've proved, son, without a shadow of a doubt, you ain't got what it takes anymore. You sit there and you thump your Bible and you say your prayers and it didn't get you anywhere. Talk about your Psalms, talk about John 3:16. Austin 3:16 says, I just whipped your ass.
Come on, that's not necessary.
All he's got to do is go buy him a cheap bottle of and try to dig back some of that courage he had in his prime. As the King of the Ring, I'm serving notice to every one of the WWE superstars. I don't give a damn what they are. They're all on the list, and that's Stone Cold's list, and I'm fixing to start running through all of them. As far as this championship match is considered, son, I don't give a damn if it's Davey Boy Smith or Shawn Michaels. Steve Austin's time has come. And when I get the shot, you're looking at the next WWE champion. And that's the bottom line, because Stone Cold said so.
Obviously, anything but humble, the fourth prestigious King of the Ring, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Well, thanks for hanging out, guys. I figured for 2K Showcase, we'll do one match at a time. I hope you had fun. I know I did. And I'll catch you in the next video. If you dig this, want to see more, please hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Lights a fire under my ass to do more work on YouTube and share stuff with you. So yeah, much appreciated. And I'll see you next time. Take care.